Anyway, in the last class, what was the last thing we were talking about? Benefits for being recognized. So did we see the benefits? So we have to. Okay. But we understand the idea of a recognized party, a state political party and a national political party. So once they're recognized, they're given some benefits. I'm sure you already know, but just for the sake of telling you several benefits, couple of very important benefits, and then other, not so much of a benefit, more like a preference to these parties over other kind of parties. So one of the first things is that these recognized parties, they are provided land and office space in the capitals. Either it is free of cost or at a discounted rate. So how is this a benefit? What's the benefit here? What's the benefit here? Well, isme kya fayda hai logo ko? It's basically they get prime property, and they get it for free or a discount is a bonus. But the real benefit is not that it is free or discount, because these parties they can afford. But the point is to get that much land. Delhi mein jagah kahan hai abhi? Where is the property that you can buy? They'll buy if available. And I hope you have seen their offices. Have you seen the BJP office? It's lush green property at the heart of Delhi. Where do you get such kind of benefits? Right, acres of land. They can, you know, operate from those areas. So that's definitely a big thing. Then free airtime. Free airtime. What is this? Prasar Bharati and its channels. All India Radio, Doordarshan. I hope you realize how this is a benefit. Others can also take it, but they'll have to pay, that's all. So based on their vote share in the previous election, they are given time slots. And you know, All India Radio is still a major source to reach out to the masses in this country. Right? Radio is still a major source. And these government channels. Anyway, so that's that. Then exclusive right to use a party symbol. Exclusive right. For all their party operations, contesting election, whatever they want to do. Nobody else can use that symbol. Okay? How are the parties given a symbol, by the way? So these parties, they get whatever they want and it's reserved for them. What about the other parties? I start a new party today. Can I take any symbol I want? So how do I get the symbol? No, I have to choose. Nobody allots it to me. I want jhadu, mujhe jhadu hi chahiye na. Right? So I can propose to election commission. And then election commission will see, is it secular or not? Is it creating some kind of animosity or anti-India kind of a symbol or something? And if it's okay, if they find it not objectionable, then they will put it into a list what is called freely available symbols. And then at the time of election, all these other parties have to choose from that list of symbols. That is why practically it doesn't matter, because every party chooses the same symbol. Aam Aadmi Party is not a national party in India, but at the national election, nobody else is going to choose Jhadu. So they only choose it. So virtually it's reserved for them also. There are only 7 national political parties, right? For others, nothing is reserved. But they also get the same symbol. So it's kind of a mutual understanding why mera wala nahi lena tumko. But if a conflict happens, and it does happen, rarely, because some parties in India have the same symbol, like Bahujan Samaj Party and Assam Gan Parishad. both have the symbol of elephant. But that is not a problem so much because BSP doesn't go to Assam. But if they do, and BSP also says I want elephant, and Assam Gan Parishad also says I want elephant, then we know who will get it. The National Party. They'll get the preference. Anyway, so exclusive use of a party symbol for all their operations. Then, two copies of the electoral roll for every constituency they contest election free of cost. Two copies of the electoral roll. For every constituency they contest election. Free of cost. This is also a big benefit. Even though everything is available online now. But we print it out and give it to them. Right? And I hope you realize, electoral roll is not just one or two pages. Sir, which constituency of Lok Sabha do you belong to? MP is not a constituency. Somewhere in MP, okay. Do you have any idea how many voters will be there in your constituency? Guess. 4-5 lakhs, no, I'm sure it's more than that. That's too small for a state like MP. But let's say even 5 lakhs. Wo 5 lakh voters se zyada hi hoga. But let's say 5 lakhs. 5 lakh names and their details. It's going to be a truckload of ballot paper, you know, your electoral roll. It's not going to be just, you know, thoda sa 10 lakh names are here. And two copies. So they can plan their campaign and everything. Others can also take it, they just have to pay or they have to print out on them. Nothing extraordinary, minor things. Okay. Any other benefit that you know of? Which recognized parties are given and not to others. Anything that you have read, heard, and you must have. Because election is in the season for the last 4-5 months till the next 4-5 months. This country is going to talk about election only. Star campaigner. So what's the benefit? Okay, chalo, at least you know of a star campaigner. All of you have heard of star campaigners? Yes. What is a star campaigner? Yes, Shekhar, when I say, do you know? Yes. What is it? So what do you know then? If you can't tell me what is it, the very first question ki hota kya hai, then you know nothing. Sir, what is a star campaigner? A star who campaigns. That's what it is or what else. Things are just common sense, nothing else. But the problem is in our preparation, as I have been telling you since the first class, that we don't know what am I supposed to read. We keep reading everything that the article is writing. Newspaper has written an article on star campaigner, I have read. And we realize at the end of it, we have learnt nothing. We got a lot of news. But not everything is important for me because I am preparing for exam. I am not writing a thesis on elections in India. And this is the thing which you should have developed by now. Right? 7-8 months of classes. And when you read something, what is it that is important for me? So the answer to the question which people start initially that, sir, notes mein kya likhna hai? How to make notes? Should have become clear by now, but I find it is not clear to many people still. They are still blindly just reading. For example, this question of star campaigner. If you are reading newspaper, everybody would have read it here or there, some phrase star campaigner. If you are not reading newspaper, then what can I say? But if you are reading it religiously, you would have come across this phrase definitely by now, star campaigner. Now the real questions for this phrase, no newspaper article will ever answer. Because they are not interested. So if you just read, you don't learn anything at the end of it. And a question comes, you feel lost. What our concern is always that you have to look at an issue from administrative perspective. Star campaigner is a star who campaigns. It's not important for me. How does it bother the administration? Let's say you will be the district magistrate. How is it important for you? When you will be the superintendent of police, how is it important for you? That you need to understand. As a decision maker, as law and order protector. Once you have that mindset clear, you know what to look for. And if the article is not answering, you will Google and find it out. And not just rely on whatever is written, that I will read. Even if it's not written, I will search for information. Because I know what I want to learn from here. Right? So always have that focus. That if I am the district magistrate or the SP or secretary to government of India, any of these roles, how is this important for me? Climate change summit ho gaya. So many things are being written. Is everything important for me in this exam? No. Administrative perspective. That's all I want to know. Right? And that is what should be on my fingertips in my revision stage. Because now that time is coming very fast. Your exam is here now. Hardly 4 months. Little more. And in the last 1.5 months, you have to revise. So revise what? For every topic, things should be your fingertips. At mains also, pros and cons. 4-5 words, that's all. You can't have essays and essays reading in your head. Just have to have few points. Question comes, elaborate. So your preparation has to become very crisp to the point. So anyway, what is a star campaigner? How did this idea come up? Now star campaigners are stars. Now it could be anybody. There's no rule. Party decides. Party can declare you as a star campaigner. It's up to them. Generally, you'll see these are the big political leaders. Like Narendra Modi will definitely be a star campaigner this year for their party. Amitabh Bachchan can be a star campaigner. It could be anyone. We never question it. Party gives us a list. These are star campaigners. Okay, it could be anybody. It could be donkey also. He is a star campaigner. He will go everywhere. Okay, theek hai. It could be anyone. Now, how this idea came up that we should declare a star campaigner is that, for example, Narendra Modi, let's say. Narendra Modi goes to campaign in areas. When he goes to campaign, it's not Narendra Modi who goes. It is Prime Minister Narendra Modi, at least as of now. So he doesn't go alone. When he goes, before him go 5 helicopters with SPG commandos. And when he arrives, before him arrive 20 more vehicles. Behind him are 2 ambulances, 2 fire brigades, and the entire police force is in the area. Easily 20,000 police personnel are deployed just for the security of Prime Minister. You don't realize where they are hiding even. And then when Narendra Modi arrives, let's say he has to stay overnight. Where will he stay? In your district's circuit house. You think he'll even look at that? Aapke circuit house mein rukega jaake? Kaha rukega? The poshest hotel in your area. And when he stays there, he will not stay alone. His entire team will stay, the entire hotel will be booked for him. You can't say no, that, oh, Modi ji rahenge yahan pe, SPG commanders, you go and sit in the barracks. Just a simple idea of what a trip of a prime minister to your district becomes. All this is cost. Nothing is for free here. But he's campaigning for a candidate. Right? So all this cost ultimately is for campaign. It's not government money. Government will not pay for any of this. It has to be paid by the campaign people. Narendra Modi is not an official tool. He is on a campaign. Yes, he is Prime Minister, so we are providing all this paraphernalia, but they have to pay for it. Now if the candidate has to pay for it, you know, they have election limit, expenditure limit. His election is over in one trip of Prime Minister. You know what is the limit on expenditure? How much a candidate can spend? Yeah, I mean, it depends on the constituency size. It's not fixed for every constituency. But the biggest constituency in this country, the limit is 70 lakh rupees. What is 70 lakh? One trip of Prime Minister, get Amitabh Bachchan for one day. How much does he charge? What do you think? वो आएगा 70 लाख में एक दिन के लिए आपके कैंप. नो ही इज नॉट बॉदर्ड. क्या व्हाट इज दिस? आई कैन गो टू केबीसी 1 day 2 crores. व्हाई शुड आई कम फॉर यू? वी हैव अ लिमिट ऑफ 70 लाख्स. सो इट विल एग्जॉस्ट एवरीथिंग. प्लस सेकेंडली, व्हेन नरेंद्र मोदी गोज टू कैंपेन, थिंक अबाउट इट. इज ही रियली कैंपेनिंग फॉर वन कैंडिडेट? इज ही नॉट कैंपेनिंग फॉर द पार्टी एज अ होल? He is using that platform to project the party. So why should the candidate bear the cost? It should be borne by the party. Not candidate, but the party expenditure. This is what we need to understand. Even if newspaper article is not explaining. Then my concern is, who will pay for all of it? So that's the idea. That when a party declares a star campaigner, their travel and other expenditure is not considered the expenditure of candidate, it is considered the expenditure of the party. Every party is allowed to have 20 star campaigners. Aap 20 star campaigner ghoshit kar dijiye. We don't care who they are, but their expenditure we will not count. We'll count it for the party. Recognized parties are allowed to have 40 star campaigners. So everybody is allowed 20, they are allowed 40. So what's the star campaigner now? And seriously, you're so dumb that somebody explained and immediately you can't explain what is it. And you want to lead my nation? I'll never select you also. What is a star campaigner? Zor se boli, zor se. To sunai de yahan tak. Boliye. Not candidates, campaigners. कैंडिडेट थोड़ी है लोग. द कैंपेनर्स हुज ट्रैवल एंड अदर एक्सपेंडिचर इज नॉट कंसिडर्ड द बोल. तो दिया, तीसरी बार बोलू. दैट्स हाउ मच क्लैरिटी इज एक्सपेक्टेड फ्रॉम यू. इफ यू कांट स्पीक, यू कांट राइट, फॉरगेट इट. दिस इज नॉट द एग्जाम फॉर यू. दैट्स व्हाई आई ऑलवेज आस्क यू, बोलो, गलत बोलो, ते बोलना सीखो. बिकॉज यू स्पीक करेक्ट ओनली व्हेन थिंग्स आर क्लियर. अदरवाइज यू ऑल्सो रियलाइज एस आई एम ब्लैबरिंग क्रिस. Anyway, so this is another benefit given to them. Then, you know, the way the ballot paper is printed, there is an inherent preference for recognized parties. Have you seen a ballot paper, sir? Not seen a ballot paper. Why? Have you ever voted? You have voted, na? So, how can you vote without seeing a ballot paper? अच्छा, इट वॉज लाइक हाथ उठा के वोटिंग हुआ था. 2014 लोकसभा इलेक्शन यू वोटेड. सो देयर इज अ बैलेट पेपर. इट वॉज नॉट देयर, देन हाउ कैन यू वोट? ऐसा कैसे हो सकता है कि बैलेट पेपर ही नहीं आपने वोट कर दिया? नहीं, वाइट भी थिंकिंग सर, आई वोटेड ऑन ईवीएम. ईवीएम देयर, इवन देन देयर इज अ बैलेट पेपर. द बैलेट पेपर इज प्रिंटेड. नाउ इट्स नॉट डिफरेंट फॉर डिफरेंट पीपल, बट देयर इज अ बैलेट पेपर. Oh, you did not see the EVM properly. You just went and just pressed the button. Okay, I'm going home. Isn't it? देखना चाहिए ना उसको system को. And now you observe this year, at least. ठीक है? You have seen a ballot paper. You have voted. And you're very happy about it. You're not happy also. Will you vote this year? You don't have voter ID. And how old are you? So when do you plan to get a voter ID? When you retire. How shameful. I talk to you as if you are election commissioner and he doesn't have a voter ID card. मैं आप लोगों से बात तो ऐसे करता हूँ, election commissioner बनेगा, ये voter ID card नहीं है. You know, that's what I say. What's the point of studying, reading anything when basic civic sense is not there? And sad part is, if such people qualify, what is the fate of my nation? As you see, perhaps that's the fate of my nation. Na voter ID card hai, na vote diya hai, na EVM dekha hai, but election commissioner banega wo. Kya sir, please. This year's election, even now there are 3 months. Why are you justifying I don't have voter ID? Get it done. You know how to get it done. How? Sonu bhai is telling you how to get a voter ID card. Because I know there are other kalakar bhi hain. Jaise batayenge waise karna hai. Step one. Batao. People come. So there is nothing that you will actively ever do. The CEC of India has to send some people to your house. You can go on the website of the CEO, the chief electoral officer of your state, download the form, submit it, put it online only with some proof, etc. Residence. Simple, yeah. CEO, which state you are from? Madhya Pradesh. You know CEO? What is CEO? Go and Google the website and see the CEO of your state. Every state has a CEO, chief electoral officer. The drive for enrolling new voters has started. Because next month the schedule will be announced. So a month before that it happens. It's all over in the newspaper. Only if you read carefully. So this is the time. Anybody who does not have enrollment in the electoral roll can get it done. So you, your friends, your relatives, anybody who is not a registered voter, get them registered. Batao sabko phone karke, hey, voter ID card banwaya? Nahi banwaya? Chalo banwao. Chalo, sir. Okay, good. So, anyway. So, the way the ballot paper is printed now, we have an EVM. Just a rough diagram if you see what it looks like. That's the basic, you know, structure of the unit, where there are a lot of buttons here which you can press. And on this side, that's where the ballot paper is inserted. So there is a ballot paper which is printed. So what is there? There is a name of the candidate. Then they have the party symbol. And now, since this last year's state elections, they also have the photograph of the person. Earlier they did not have the photographs. But then they realize that many candidates have similar names. So people might get confused. So photo hi lagana hai. So like this, all the names are printed. And then correspondingly you can choose which candidate it is. Now the way this is printed, the first set of names are all the candidates nominated by the recognized parties. And within that, they are alphabetically arranged. This is followed by the second set of names of candidates fielded by the other registered parties which are not recognized. And that is also alphabetically arranged. Now, I am writing in English, but it's in the regional language, in the language of that particular state, right? So, in that language, it will be alphabetically arranged. Now this is followed by the third set of candidates who are not from any party but are independent candidates, and that is also alphabetically arranged. And we all know the last candidate is always Nota. So that is how this is printed. So you can see the first set of names is of recognized parties, followed by the alphabetically arranged names of candidates from registered parties, followed by alphabetically arranged names of independent candidates. Now if there are 5-6 candidates, perhaps it doesn't matter. But you know, there are several candidates at times, 40, 50, a lot of candidates contest. And in that case, even one EVM is not sufficient, because the total number of candidates an EVM can have is 16. So the moment you have a 17th candidate, in fact 16th candidate, because Nota is the 17th automatically, you have to have the second EVM. The moment you have 32 candidates, you have to have a third EVM. Right? And also, the maximum number of EVMs that can be connected to each other, the total number of candidates can be 63. 64th being Nota. That means the moment you have 64th human candidate, you can't use EVM. You have to go to paper ballot. You can have only 4 together. and that pretty much largely it covers up. But in case you cross 64, then you have to go back to paper ballot only. And then this becomes very important because it will run in pages. Your ballot paper will not be a single page, there will be many pages to it. So those who are written first, there is some inherent advantage, preference, you can say. So anyway, I just told you so many things about EVM also. Okay, so that's one thing. One more. You know, if a candidate dies before election, before the polling day, a candidate dies for some reason. Then if the candidate belongs to recognized party, then election is postponed. And the party is given 1 week to replace their candidate. बस इतना ही ऐसे मत देखो लिख लो. So for all other types of candidates, election will happen. Election will not stop. Now this is not a random advantage. You might think as it happens almost in every election this happens. You know, you can see that it's a statistical probability only that this can happen. Lok Sabha election, there are 543 constituencies of election. Even if you take an average of only 10 candidates per constituency, it is 5,000 people contesting election. It's a probability one of them can disappear. Right? Ho to sakta hai, aur hota hai. It happened in 2014 election. In one constituency, this is a very interesting event. In Andhra of that time, today also it's in Andhra only, I don't forget the name of the constituency. But there was a constituency, and what happened? About 1 week or so before the election, the candidate died in a car accident. And the candidate was not from a recognized party. So election happened as per the schedule, and interestingly that candidate won. The dead candidate won. And then you wonder, what kind of people are they? Then think maybe it was a sympathy vote. But even then, what's the point voting for a dead candidate? What kind of people will vote? And that's a majority. Majority will get. And then you realize, oh, actually, these are all the people in the constituency. In that constituency, people are such that they don't like to read newspaper. Perhaps they thought that next month, booklet will come. I'll read the booklet. Now, election happened before that. So they did not know what happened. Do you find any resemblance with these kind of people? Do you want to be such kind of people, so outdated in their knowledge? Never do this. Because I know a lot of you do this thinking smart preparation. If there's one thing I've always asked you to religiously do and follow is newspaper. I never asked you to make notes from newspaper. Tell me if I'm wrong. I have never said make notes. Main to kabhi bolta hi nahi. Because that is idiocy. Booklet already notes are there. That is okay. If you want to make notes, that is also okay. That's your wish. But you can't prepare from booklets. They can be additional source of preparation. They cannot be the source of preparation. And you know, it's not that you will not qualify, that's why I'm saying this. You will qualify, you may. But I have a philosophical problem with this kind of attitude, because this nation will not qualify if you behave like that. You know, imagine the Secretary to Government of India doesn't read newspaper. No Joint Secretary reads newspaper. Can you believe where this country is heading then? So when they make a policy, they only have information till the last month's booklet. That also they are reading slowly. What happened in November, booklet of December tells them, and they are taking time to read it till now. And the recent booklet they have bought from the market, it gives December information. Why is it such a big difficult task to read newspaper? You think you will make do justice to this responsibility by not reading newspaper? That's why, you know, why you should read newspaper is to start liking it. It's part of your job. Otherwise, you're a disgrace to civil service. So people say, sir, till when should I read newspaper? Ye itna kasht kyun hota newspaper padhne se? And you know my answer is, till the last day of your life. It's being human, a good citizen, to be aware about what is happening around you. And especially policy makers should be even more aware. Not just around you, but in the world. Latest technology, latest development, pata honai chahiye aapko. So anyway, what will we do? The winning candidate is already dead. What do we do now? What can we do? Is there too many options? Kya kare? By election. It's as if they died after. So anyway, recognized parties also get this benefit that election will be postponed by 1 week. Then, there are many other benefits also, but these are some major ones. Let me tell you one benefit which is not yet there but has been proposed. It's a proposed benefit. And you know, the moment you write a proposed benefit, your answer suddenly becomes 2-star better. Because a proposed benefit means current affairs. And this tells the examiner that, boss, this is a very good candidate. He has prepared systematically. So he knows what are the benefits. He also knows what are the futuristic benefits which are being talked about, and he can relate current affairs here and write a good answer. Very good candidate. Because what you've written, everybody else will write. But if 2 months from now in the newspaper you find government is proposing something, that should be written here. Open your notes, add it here, so that when you revise, it again comes together. This I have been telling you for so long. This is what is called systematic preparation. So always there should be some current affairs in your answer, somewhere or the other, even in a theoretical question. It's a rule of thumb. And I know I tell you this, and you're like, ha, theek hai. But when I see the answer, nobody writes any example. You have to be conscious in answer writing practice. Write answer, and then you should have a checklist. All the things I have told, any teacher has told, that answer mein example hona chahiye, answer should be always futuristic ending, answer should be like this, write in paragraphs, write in points. When you write an answer, open that checklist and see, have I done all this? If you keep doing this for every answer, the 100th answer you'll write, you'll not have to check, automatically your mind does all of that. Otherwise, you know what happens, I told you something, somebody else told you something, it doesn't get implemented. So when you bola, there should always be a current affairs example, you heard. Honestly, tell me, do you think in your next answer you're going to consciously do this? You boss, ek answer likhna hai. Kuch nahi hota hai. That's why I always have things written down. At least for answer writing, there should be one page of checklist. Your thoughts, what have you learned? Every time you write an answer, check. If you're not doing it, start doing it. Gradually, months and months, then you don't have to check. Automatically, your behavior is like that always you'll give an example. Okay, sir. Have you heard of state funding of election? इसका एक ही आंसर हो सकता है यस या नो राइट ऐसे देखने की जरूरत नहीं है इज इट बिकॉज इट्स 8 o'clock और यू एक्चुअली बिकम डम सिंस द लास्ट टाइम आई मेट यू दैट हैव यू हर्ड ऑफ स्टेट फंडिंग ये क्या होता है से यस और नो इफ यू हर्ड गुड अदरवाइज आई टेल यू हैव यू हर्ड ऑफ स्टेट फंडिंग यस गुड व्हाट इज स्टेट फंडिंग सो शी हैज नॉट हर्ड
Government provides the money for election expenditures so that
It doesn't provide, but that's the proposal. Yeah. That in India, we should have the state or the government funding the election of parties. Right? Why not? Should we not? Leave that, we'll discuss it some other time. But the important point for us right now is that this state funding of election proposal is only for recognized parties, which your government is considering. In the proposed state funding of election, it is only for recognized political parties. Okay. Now see, all these benefits that we have seen, it's free, right? Free land or discounted land, free airtime. Lot of benefits are given for free. Now it's free for the party, but is it free for the government? What do you think? Is it free for the government? No. It's a cost. When I give you land, that land has a cost. When I give you airtime, it's a revenue lost. If I would have given it to some advertisement, I would have earned revenue. It's a revenue loss. So it's a cost for me. And when it's a cost for the government, it means it is a cost for the people. It's people's money. That means in a way, people's money is being used in the functioning of these parties. In a way, you are funding them. Right? So if you are funding them, don't you think you have the right to know what they are doing with it? It's your money after all. In this regard comes a very important issue. If you ask me, this is the most important issue around elections in our country. Especially in the recent times, Election Commission has come up with some kind of orders which make it even more important. And that is, do these parties come under the RTI Act or not? Recognized political parties and the RTI Act. You know RTI? Yes? What is RTI? Huh? Right to information. Wow, yeah, you're so intelligent. I never realized you would know this. What is RTI? You have heard of RTI, right? You've heard of RTI? Suna to hoga hi na RTI. Have you ever filed an RTI? How many of you filed an RTI, raise your hand? Ever in your life? RTI 1, 2, 2.5. That's all. Madam, what do you think? How many people are sitting in the class right now? Approximately? 300? And not even 3 people have filed RTI. So looks like RTI is useless. अगर यूजफुल होता तो ज्यादा लोगों ने फाइल किया होता तो. बट व्हेन आई रीड योर आंसर्स ऑन आरटीआई, व्हेन एवर यू विल राइट एन आंसर ऑन आरटीआई, आई रीड योर राइटिंग, आरटीआई इज अ गेम चेंजर फॉर गवर्नेंस इन इंडिया. आरटीआई हैज रेवोल्यूशनाइज्ड पीपल्स पार्टिसिपेशन. आरटीआई हैज ब्रॉट ट्रांसपेरेंसी एंड अकाउंटेबिलिटी इन द गवर्नेंस सिस्टम. इट हैज क्रिएटेड एक्टिव सिटीजनरी. यहां तो नहीं दिख रहा कुछ. नॉट इवन 1% ऑफ द एजुकेटेड लर्नड पीपल मोटिवेटेड इन गवर्नमेंट हैव यूज्ड दिस. सो इफ आई गो आउट इन माय सोसाइटी, व्हाट विल बी द रेट ऑफ यूसेज ऑफ आरटीआई? इफ इन दिस काइंड ऑफ इंटेलिजेंसिया, इट्स नॉट इवन 1%. तो बाहर तो वैसे ही लोग पेट खाने में लगे हुए हैं सिर्फ, उसको तो लाइवलीहुड का इश्यू है, वो कहां आरटीआई करने वाला है? सो देयर ओनली टू पॉसिबिलिटीज. यू हैव नेवर फाउंड द यूटिलिटी ऑफ आरटीआई, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, आरटीआई इज यूजलेस. बट यू आर सेइंग नो, आरटीआई इज वेरी गुड, देन समथिंग एल्स इज यूजलेस. हु यू नो द आंसर? There are two entities, like you and RTI. One of them has to be useless. That's why you have not filed RTI. So you yourself are saying RTI is very useful. Active citizenry, governance, transparency, accountability, what not. Okay, so if RTI is not useless, then think about it. It's a very important question that a lot of things you know, you write, but even you are not doing all of that.